My name is Ian and welcome to Planted. I'm on a mission to share my plant knowledge with you so that you have more success at home. In this episode, it's the summer wisteria amputation. Here we go. I'm a big fan of summer pruning wisteria. Lots of growth. You can really get it under control. Here it is before pruning, and here it is after pruning. You'll see that there's a lot of branch has been removed, a lot of foliage has been removed, and I've really opened up to be able to see the shingles behind. This lets the sunlight in and really ripens the wood for next year's flowers. Now, whenever you start to prune a wisteria, don't be afraid. Get in there, get stuck in, and there's a lot of branches and leaves and shoots that you will be removing, and that's perfectly okay. When you start pruning your wisteria, you need to make a plan, and I like to start low down and trim off everything that I can easily reach. And what you're doing is you are removing growth so that you can better see what you've got. You can't be expected to go in there first time and make every cut the perfect cut in just the right place. So don't be afraid to essentially butcher your plant to uncover the framework, and then you can go back and tidy up those wayward cuts that are a bit clumsy and start to bring your plant under control. Here I am working on the ground and just removing lots of excessive growth. It's not difficult and it doesn't take that long, but you really do need to uncover what it is that you want. Now, I'm going to train three or four branches to go up and over the door frame, and I want to choose the best ones. I don't want to have one stem have three branches and keep all those three branches. I want to have two or three stems or four stems coming up the door frame and then have more stems on top of that. And the reason is that if one of my top stems dies or breaks or snaps, I've got others that will let me keep the growth going. So you never ever want to have just one stem going over one item. If it breaks, the whole thing's gone. Here I am untangling it from the light. It managed to find a little spot that it could hang on to, and it did a great job. I've been pruning wisteria now for over 30 years, and I don't pay any real care and attention. I just want to get the plant under control, and I want it to grow where I want it in my time frame. Do I make wrong cuts? Absolutely. Does it bother me? Not in the slightest. Here we are in early August, which is a great time to do summer pruning. We've got the rest of August, all of September, and part of October. Certainly August and September will see this plant put out a few new shoots. And that's okay, that's just fine, no problems there whatsoever. I am not going to prune this whole wisteria at one time. It's quite a physical job. If you don't like getting on a ladder, then you might need to get someone to come and help you. But I don't want to make a difficult job harder by having to start it and finish it all in one go. Break up your time. It can be very hot, very tiring. Get your tools together, make sure that you've got your sharp clippers. And here I am about to tie up the three or four shoots that I saved to go over the door frame. But I'm cutting my lines ahead of time so that when I'm on the top of my ladder, I'm not then trying to cut the twine. Once you're ready to start climbing, it's important that you sight your ladder very carefully. This is the A-frame ladder, which rests against itself. I've had great success with them, because I can pull it away from the house and get the exact spot that I want. But ultimately, I will be moving on to ladders that I lean up against the house as I go higher. This whole job took me probably 45 minutes. And I like to break things up into stages. So here I'm doing the door frame, the lower window, and I'll also start to prune some of the mass that I can reach from all that growth to the right as you look at it now. Then I'm going to stop. And I've had great success in the past in doing wisteria pruning and other prunings in stages, rather than trying to go in there all at once, chop it up into small bite-sized pieces, and it becomes very, very manageable. I'm lucky that my house has got a very large overhang. It's got not one layer of shingles, but two layers of shingles because it's very old. And I'm able to put in stainless steel screws very judiciously into my house, and then I can tie my wisteria to those. And it works very well. If you've got brick, you might need to drill a pilot hole, put a little plug in, and then put your stainless steel screw into that. But this is my preferred method. If you don't want to do it that way, that's okay. But you're going to have to find some way to attach your wisteria up to the house so that it's properly supported. I will let you figure out what is the best way for you. Now, when I'm up there, I'm constantly lifting and rotating and trying to look at the branches that I've pruned and what can I do better and how can I make sure that my pruning is effective. So yet again, please don't think that you have to strive for perfection the very first time. If you've got a branch that is 5 feet long and you know that you want to cut it back to about 5 feet long, why don't you cut it back 4 feet long, leave a foot that you can then come back to and train it a bit more specifically, but you're not looking for that perfect cut. So I do tend to thin my branches and go a little bit more, a little bit more, and a little bit more, and I get the thin pruning that I actually want. Now, wisteria has got the ability to put out branches seemingly overnight. The last couple of weeks, I've had various branches come out from the lower part of this project, and they come into what is a very narrow path. And they'll put on a foot of growth in 3 days. I don't come out for a few days, or I don't use this particular access. And there's a branch growing right in its way. So those are the ones that you want to cut back completely. And you want to leave the thicker branches because that's your framework. And in the previous videos, I've talked about a hand. It's a nice thick branch that breaks into 4 or 5 different shoots. And that's where we'll be having the majority of our flowers next year. Now, as you saw earlier in the video, this wisteria did in fact flower for me this year. I was very, very happy that it did that, and I'm hoping to get an awful lot more flowers next year. I'm now moving my A-frame ladder further to the right so I can start pruning off lots of stray branches and excessive growth from the main plant. And I've done this method before, and I'll come back in a few days or a week or so with a big ladder and do everything above me. But what that means is that I'm not tempted on my big ladder to reach over and cut lower branches that I can easily get on this ladder. It makes the job much more manageable, and you really are breaking up the task into pieces. So this is the wisteria amputation. Get out there, get your wisteria under control. Thank you for watching Planted. Tell your friends, tell your family. And as ever, happy planting.